Okay, today is Sunday, July 31st. The whole month went by so fast. I mean, of course, when it's summertime, when it's nice and hot, time flies. The winters, not so much. Those drag on and on and on and on and on. I said it's gonna be totally cloudy. Poop, I just stepped on poop or at least it was dry. So now I'm gonna make some money. And that was supposed to mean. I don't know, that's what I heard, like, you know. Because yeah, we live in a world where a lot of us, we're not aware how we just, you know, get triggered, and we want to rescue. Whatever, you know. I mean, those things on the Twister, you know, the bird app, the social media. I should be the anti-social media because we are more divided than ever. And not in the sense, you know, like the crackers say, you know. It's like every time our African-American brothers and sisters demand reparations, which they don't no more. They all became fixated on these freaks, you know, whatever, transgender, whatever, I don't know. And they're like, look at that. It's like, yeah, I'm just like, I only know about them because of these people. Like, you know, they always, you know, they're, I don't really, to tell the truth, I avoid African-American content, you know, like the plague. I don't. But every now and then, you know, it's like somebody, you know, that I, because I mostly like read African Twitter. You know what's happening over there. I feel like it's important to stay on top of the mother continent because it's going this way. Why is he going this way? I mean, he's taking this lane instead of the middle lane. I guess this is where he live at. So this park right there. So yeah, sometimes they retweet some bullshit. It's like, I mean, it's the same shit that's been going on for the longest time, you know? This shit has been going on for the longest time. You know, the circus, but they never call it gender. You know, some gay shit. So, I guess that's why, you know, that's how they start, you know, they started like, oh yeah, it's gay shit, whatever, and I was like, oh no, that shit is gender, and like, you go, what, you mean like your mating rituals, you know, where you do everything to get some dick, you know, whatever. You know, now that shit got something to do with gender. Oh wait, the other one say no parking Tuesday, and this one say no parking Monday. Tomorrow, wonder what they're gonna do. So, yeah, I mean, and they don't, you know. I mean, I try to warn people, this is bullshit, you know. I dedicated 10 years of my life to try to do something for, you know, post-op transsexuals only, and that was impossible. And it was actually, you know, African-Americans the ones most against it, you know, because they get so triggered, you know, like, how can that bitch look better than me? You know, it's like, and, you know, whatever, you know, all they say, you know. And sometimes I think maybe we was put over here to shame these bitches into being women again, you know. They cry like a, they squeal like a pig and whatever, you know, but they don't change one bit. They don't change one bit. The ratchet ways and the bullshit, you know. I mean, like, how are you going to go out with a bonnet and Monique tell you, you know, hey, take some pride, you're representing queen. And they ate her alive just because of that. That's this. You cannot say nothing to these wenches, you know. I mean, like, not that Monique. I mean, it's like, she's any better, you know. She was preaching, you know, like in the 90s, I forgot, that you do whatever it takes to please your man. I guess, you know, that's how she started wearing a strap on. I don't know. I'm gonna die single, and I'm perfectly okay when I see all these fat hags. I mean, like, is there anything more pathetic, you know, to end up, you know, with a gay man? Even if he's your friend, even if it's just like whatever, like, I don't. I mean, I think, and they have made it in like, oh, they go hand in hand, you know, like horse and carriage. Yeah, which horse and carriage don't go together. That's the mind of the cracker. But everybody just normalize it. Everybody, I guess they didn't know they was doing so well. Now they're expanding. I never seen anybody in this damn restaurant. I don't know. Maybe the mafia. I don't know. It's like I never seen nobody here. I guess after midnight, right? I'm not here after midnight. So. I'm just so tired. Again. Anyway, which is a better reason why I need to continue doing my morning walkings. So I need to go back to yoga as soon as possible. But I don't want to pass out in the yoga class. Especially this yoga class that is free. It's very hard. It is very hard. It's a very bougie studio downtown. But they give us 1 hour, 1 hour and a half free. They give us a free yoga class. Oh my God, the sewer is right there. It just smells like you're in DR. For real, well, that's what they say. I never been there. And I don't even want to go there. I do want to go to IT. You know, one day I might go. I think I might want to go to IT. You know, and yeah, just I want to, well, I don't know, it's kind of hot for me. It's too hot for me. It is too hot for me. Maybe in January, I don't know. I mean, yeah, that's the thing when you get old and you're trying to catch up, but I really want to go to, you know, to Emperor Jean-Jacques Dessalines' home, you know, even to visit the ruins of Sanssouci. Those are the things that excite me. Thank you. Yeah, it's just, I'm glad I can pause this thing. I was getting so emotional just imagining, you know, just how different the world could be if, you know, we had supported them and we had focus. But, you know, that's, I know they're gonna say it's complicated. It's always like, it is complicated. Come on, this is the only thing, you know, I am a reproach against Venezuelan people. You know, if, you know, the Haitian Empire, you know, funded the Bolivarian Revolution twice that we know of. I mean, it was like top secret. This is also why I'm like, really, you hiding this? And now that it came out, I mean, it's been coming out. I mean, people blogging about it and stuff. And still, it's not taking its proper place in Venezuelan history. It's shameful. It is shameful, you know. And they want to put Simón Bolívar as the top shit, because there is that agenda, you know, the agenda Creole. There is that Creole agenda in the whole continent, right, where all the superheroes was crackers, you know, in Mexico too, and like, so that's just why we are revamping the movement in Mexico. I mean, there's only like 2-3 voices of us, you know. You know, they think they're smart. They think all these heroes, you know, they liberated us from the Europeans. You know, but they liberated us for them, you know. That's exactly like in Mexico, this hero is supposed to be the father of Mexico's independence. You know, he, you know, at that time, you know, we belonged to the French. So that's why he came out and to liberate it, to give it back to the crown at best, you know, but it's more like to keep it to themselves, you know, the mulattoes, the, you know, I mean, like you got to read the Black Jacobins, which I still haven't finished. It's so hard for me to read. I usually read in the summertime, you know, when I'm in the train, like 2-hour ride, it's like, you know, it's like now it's very uncomfortable, so I have to be standing up, and I don't know, I just feel like kind of like learning another way of living, you know. They said it was totally cloudy right now. I'm like, and it's gonna be cloudy the whole day, allegedly, that's what they say. I forgot my Obama phone. So that's okay, I don't need that shit. What was that? I didn't see nothing, it just wanted to land in the middle of the road. Another one. Look at this. The other day I ran into this guy, I keep running into him because he live around here, you know, it's like he came to my house a couple of times, you know, when I was a slut. And look at that, they just ran the lights, even when it was told to them that, you know, watch out for the, go ahead, oh shit, the speeding cameras. You go like hesitating, like, you're hesitating. Yeah, they announced last week that, you know, more cameras installed. Anybody speeding or breaking the law, you know, our Beavis and Butthead. Breaking the law, breaking the law. Oh my God. So, they're gonna terrorize people and make money at the same time, I guess. But a lot of people, they don't even care. There's an ambulance. A lot of people, they don't even care, you know? They don't give a damn. Because that's like the only thing they got. So they're trying to hold on to their reckless driving, at least they say, you know, it's like, I got money to pay the tickets. Or whatever, I don't know. That should have been like a constant. They're a joke, you know. They say that we're enforcing this, and then, oh, it's election season. We don't want to, you know, ruffle nobody's feathers because we need them to go out and vote. We need them to go out and vote, and then they stop. So it's like the same thing as when I was growing up. I was supposed to be grounded for a week, whatever, and there was nobody in the house. I mean, that was a stupid example, you know. But it was like stuff like that. We know that they never, you know, because it was never home. So it was like, don't watch television for a whole week. And there was nobody home. So, especially my baby brother and sister, it was like, that's all they did. That's all they did. So where was I? I wonder what happened. Yeah, that beautiful building over there in the background. Yeah, it's public housing. As I was wondering, you know, it's so pretty, but who wanna live right next to the highway? You know, I think it's I don't know. Yes, the Major Deegan. But now people, they live, whatever, in a sewer. I mean, if they, like, allow them to live, you know. Because they lost all sense of, you know, disgust, right? We're talking about, you know, I hope, I'm going to keep saying it, you know, Doctor, be serious. Doctor with an H at the end. And yeah, he's been doing several shows. I'm behind with Brother Rich on 363, Black Magic 363. I think I finally remember. It was 365, no, it's 363. And so he's talking about parasites, you know, that's his forte. And how, you know, I mean, most diseases, they thrive on sugar. So. Yeah, talking about this guy, you know, it's like, you know, I mean, he looked like shit. I don't know who I was. I mean, he gave up. I can tell something happened to him, you know, his teeth are like, but he's always been a nice guy, you know, whatever I found him. So he started like, we found each other, I think it was like, you know, by university, and say, yeah, I'll walk with you. You know, so he wanted to come to my house. You know, but so I was already walking, so I said, you know, for a while, I said, it's like, I got really tired because, you know, I don't know why I got so tired, you know. I was just like, because I walked a lot. I was waiting for PC Richards to open, because for the very first time, you know, this woman, she was very nice to me, and she told me I can buy the service plan within 30 days. It's like, I thought that was a big no-no, like they usually tell you, oh no, you gotta buy it right now. you gotta buy it right now, the service bond. I didn't have the $15 at the time. You know, I went to exchange it, and now they're only doing one time, and then I think kind of like what she explained to me was that every time you do an exchange, you can buy the $15 service plan for 2 years. I didn't know that. So now I have, 2 years, whatever, you know. The other one was still good. It was just like really beat up. And I used to have like 2 burners because Marcus, he liked to cook. So I was like, okay, but now that, you know, I broke out with him because, you know, I need to stay focused and go back to Mexico. I'm like, there's no way I can stay here and then just wait until like, you know, the fan get, you know, totally smeared, you know, whatever. If you know what I'm trying to say, you know, I'm like, no, I mean, this shit is really bad. I mean, I don't know how you do it. Oh, that's what I wanted to talk to about, you know, I wanted to talk about, and it's just like, oh my God, because I'm seeing, I don't know, I was walking, somehow I started seeing that, damn, this is going to get prolonged even more. Because I was like looking in Brooklyn yesterday. I was on the bus and I see that they have even the gas prices even lower than here. I think it was like $4.39. Over here they are $4.49. And mysteriously, I mean, like not mysteriously, I know they are printing more money and they are subsidizing. They're subsidizing, you know, the price of gas. Because there's no effing way, you know. Yeah, like I said, there ain't no way that, you know, the price of gas is still in $4.49. I don't see that, but, you know. And I see some of the prices, like, you know, I went to Costco. I mean, they used to have these 3 quarts. It was like humongous bottle of extra virgin olive oil. And it was all from one country, which is the way I understand. That's the way, because I did some research. And, you know, everybody was saying, yeah, the most important is for you to get the olives all from one country. Because, you know, they have from this country, from that country, it's just like it just lose a lot of quality control. So that's how I thought, it's like, oh yeah, Costco got one that is from one country only. So now they don't. And I was like, yeah, the only one they got, it was organic extra virgin olive oil, but they don't tell you where the olives are from. They won't tell you where the olives are from. You know, it's just like, they just say selected and blah, blah, blah. It just means like, BS, BS. And now instead of 3 quarts, it's 2 quarts. That's a smaller bottle. I mean, it was the same price. And I was like, oh, I mean, But that was, I think, the only casualty. I mean, what I got, I was like, I got my raw honey that's still coming in. You know, $11.99, I think. $11.95 a bottle. It's pretty good. I mean, especially for the winter, like, really keep you, you know, you want to stay, you know, healthy the whole winter. 1 spoonful a day. Of that shit, and like, of course, you know, moringa tea, you know, and stuff, you know, but I mean, I always felt like, you know, and I still don't remember the name of the papyrus that, you know, the Germans, you know, like, they bought these papyrus from Kemet long time ago, and now they say the Hahnemann is the one who invented homeopathy, and was like, yeah, right. I never believed that for a second. You know, because like Dr. Clark say, they got it, they stole it. You know, it's nothing that they got it. And sure enough, but I just like can't remember the name of that papyrus where they said a lot of the uses for honey. And they talk about homeopathy, how to do homeopathy and stuff. And I'm telling you, my dad, he was a party animal for the longest time. He was not supposed to live that long. He lived to be 83 years old because of homeopathy. That shit is, oh well, because of his superior DNA. He had like, he never got sick, you know, never saw him sick ever. I don't know, I wasn't there the last 30 years, I think I'm just gonna start walking because it's a Sunday and, you know. I don't know, just don't even, I'll wait a little bit more. And it just looked like, again, you know, we have had several scares, you know, mostly on social media. I mean, like, but now, oh, here it comes. And it just seemed like it's just gonna perpetuate this BS, you know, secula seculorum. Gas prices gonna become stable. I'm gonna continue with the BS, and for how long? That is the question. For how long? For how long the prices?